Hi, today we are going to discuss ARP interview questions and answers. It is related to the CCNA interview questions and answers. So, our first question here is ARP. What is ARP? ARP is Address Resolution Protocol. Address Resolution Protocol means it is a type of a protocol, we can say it is a type of a protocol that usually resolves the address. Fine. So, that usually resolves the address. So, the question is then what type of address it resolves. We basically know there are two types of address. Okay, the first address is IP address. What we know is an IP address, and another we know MAC address. There are two types of address. So ARP is actually related to these two types of addresses. Like simply, if we are talking about this ARP, address resolution protocol. So what is ARP? So it resolves the address. So we know here we see that there are two addresses. So ARP is related to only these two addresses. We can define ARP as it is a type of a protocol that is used to resolve the addresses. That will be the definition. So what type of addresses it resolves? ARP resolves IP to MAC, IP address to MAC address. So we can say that with the help of an IP address of a assigned on a device, we can identify the MAC address of that device. So this is the definition. Okay, so let us see here what it is written. Address resolution protocol, it is a network protocol, fine, which is used to map a network layer protocol address, IP address, IP address to a data link layer address, a MAC address. So it basically maps IP address to MAC address. So this is the function of ARP, and this is address resolution protocol. ARP basically resolves IP address to the corresponding MAC address. Fine. So our next question is, ARP works at which layer and why? Why it is worked firstly we have to tell on which layer it works. It works on a data link layer. Okay, the layer 2. It works on a data link layer. ARP is implemented by the network protocol driver, and its packets are encapsulated by the Ethernet headers and transmitted. Fine. So it works on a data link layer. Okay. So because it is related to the MAC address, so that's why it works on a data link layer. Our next question is, explain the use of ARP. Actually, we have to tell about the use of ARP. Why we use ARP? Whenever we are in need of a MAC address, we have to know the MAC address of a device. So at that time we can use ARP, okay, through which we can know the MAC address of a device. So we can say that the use of ARP is to identify the MAC address of a host from its IP address. Fine. We see here what it is written. If a host in an Ethernet network, fine, wants to communicate with another host, okay, it can communicate only if it knows the MAC address of other host. ARP is used to get the MAC address of a host from its IP address. Fine. Let us see the next question. Our next question is, what is an ARP table cache? So what is ARP table? Address resolution protocol table. So it is basically a table that maintains the mapping of IP address and the MAC address. So we can see that ARP maintains a table that contains the mappings between IP address and MAC address. This table is called ARP table. Fine. So our next question is, what is the source and the destination IP address in an ARP request and an ARP reply packet? Okay. So in ARP, source and destination IP request and ARP reply packet. So ARP request, here we can see that the source address will be, I think 0000 it should be, but it is written here, MAC address of the host which transmitted the ARP request packet. Sorry, it is written that the ARP request, whatever the device that is requesting for ARP, that source address means that device MAC address, okay, is our source sender's MAC address. Okay, a source is a MAC address of a host, okay, and destination is a FFFFFFF broadcast, okay, and for the ARP reply, source will be the MAC address of the host replying for ARP request, and the destination should be MAC address of the host which generated the ARP request packet. So these are the, this is the source and destination IP address in ARP request and ARP reply packet. What it is mean to say here that that source and destination IP address in ARP request means the device which is requesting for ARP, that device address is source IP address, and the destination will be from where it is means requesting, and the opposite is for the ARP reply packet. Now our next question is, what is the size of ARP request and ARP reply packet? What is the size of ARP request and ARP reply packet? The size of ARP request and ARP reply packet is 28 bytes. Okay, now let's see the next question. One, how can we differentiate between an ARP request packet and an ARP reply packet? So the differentiation between an ARP request packet and an ARP reply packet is that we can differentiate ARP request packet from ARP reply packet using the operation field in the ARP packet. So operation field in the ARP packet. Okay, fine. So for ARP request, this operation field should is 1, and for ARP reply it is 2. Fine. What is proxy ARP? Proxy ARP, it is the process in which one system respond to the ARP request of the another system. Proxy ARP is the process in which one system respond to the request of the other system. The meaning of this is that if you are requesting like an ARP request for one device, but the other device responds for it. Okay, so this is the proxy ARP. What is gracious ARP? In a layman term, if I say that gracious ARP is that ARP when when a device is assigned to IP address. Okay, so for resolving the IP address, a gracious ARP is used because the device wants to ensure that nobody in the network have the same IP address. So that's why for resolving the IP address we are using a gracious ARP. Okay, well, we will see here what is written. It is written that when a host send a ARP request to resolve its own IP address, it is called ARP request. In simple terms we can say, in the ARP request packet, the source IP address and the destination IP address are filled with the same source IP address itself, the destination MAC address, the broadcast address. Gracious ARP is used by the host after it is assigned an IP address by DHCP server to check whether the another host in network does not have the same IP address. Okay, if the host does not get ARP reply for a gracious ARP request, it means that there is no another host which is configured with the same IP address. Okay, if the host gets ARP reply, then it means that another host is also configured with the same IP address. Fine. So the meaning of the whole this sentence is that if a host is assigned with some IP address, fine. So to check that whether the another device in the same network or in the network have the same IP address or not, so to resolve that problem, it uses IP address. Okay, so what is reverse ARP? Reverse ARP is the in ARP, simple ARP, we know that it is resolving the MAC address from the IP address, and the reverse is true for the reverse ARP. Means from the MAC address we are resolving the IP address. Okay, so here we see the definition is written. ARP is used to obtain DSP device IP address when the MAC address is already known. Fine. What is inverse ARP? So see here, it is a different terminology, different term. It is different from reverse ARP. Inverse ARP, inverse ARP, what does it do? It dynamically maps DLSI to remote IP address. Okay, when frame relay is configured, frame relay, we will see questions from the frame relay also. It is layer 2, it is used in a layer 2 device. Okay, switch, when we are configuring a switch, we will use this frame relay to connection between two types of networks, or connection over internet also frame relay is used. So here we are seeing that what is inverse ARP. Inverse ARP, it maps a local DLSI. What is DLSI? DLSI is like a link connection identifier, digital link connection identifier or something, digital link connection identifiers to remote IP address. So it maps a DLSI to remote IP address. Okay, fine. So these are the questions related to the this ARP Okay, so we will see our next section in next video. Thank you very much.